Hi everyone, welcome back to SG Dr. Wellness. I'm Dr. Chen Yiming. As I speak today, the daily numbers of newly diagnosed COVID-19 patients in Singapore are hitting new highs. Fortunately, the number of vaccinated people in Singapore has gone beyond 80%. Once again, to protect yourself and everyone you love, get yourself vaccinated if you haven't already, wear a mask and avoid crowded areas if possible. We're all aware that the Temasek Foundation has been issuing the pulse oximeter for every household in Singapore in the month of July and August. If you have it, do you know how to use it? And if you have been using it, do you know what are the healthy or unhealthy numbers on the pulse oximeter? Are there other factors which may result in a falsely low oxygen reading? In today's video, I'll be sharing this information with you. And if you're new to my channel, click on the subscribe and notification button now. The main function of the finger pulse oximeter is to measure the blood oxygen levels in the body. The device works by emitting beams of red and infrared light that passes through your fingertip. Sensors at the other end of the device will then measure the amount of light absorbed by our blood. And through this process, it can estimate the amount of oxygen carrying hemoglobin in our bloodstream. And at the same time, it can measure the number of pulsations within the fingertip and give an approximation of our pulse rate. Do note that there are a few factors that may make our oxygen levels on the pulse oximeter appear falsely low. 1. If you are a smoker, your oxygen levels may always be slightly lower. 2. Fingernail polish can affect the absorption of the red light by our finger blood vessels and result in oxygen level being falsely low. Ladies, please take note. 3. When you are cold, the circulation on our fingertips may be reduced and that can affect the accuracy of the pulse oximeter reading. 4. When the finger of the patient is too small, such as in a very young child, the issued adult pulse oximeter may not be able to read the oxygen and pulse or give a wrong reading. So do bear in mind that the pulse oximeter is not 100% accurate. It is generally used in the medical settings, in hospitals and outpatient clinics, for the monitoring of patients who have conditions that can affect blood oxygen levels, such as lung conditions like pneumonia, lung cancer, asthma, and chronic obstructive lung disease, or COPD for short. It can also be used to measure heart conditions like heart attack and heart failure. The COVID-19 virus can cause blood oxygen to drop to dangerously low levels, sometimes even when you feel relatively well or have no other symptoms of the virus, and this is termed silent pneumonia. The blood oxygen levels are displayed as SpO2 on the device. Blood oxygen levels 95% and above are considered healthy. Levels between 90 to 94% is low, and if it drops below 90%, it becomes dangerously low. The heart rate is displayed usually as HR or PR. Generally, we accept normal heart rate in adults as between 60 to 100. As I've discussed in my other video on healthy heart rate, some very fit adults may have heart rates slightly lower than 60. Feel free to access that video by clicking on the top right of your screen now. In cases of COVID-19 infection, the heart rate tends to be higher, usually more than 100. Now I'm going to show you how to use the pulse oximeter. Step 1. Place the finger into the clip, making sure that the meaty part of your finger is directly above the pulsating red light. Step 2. Press the on button on the device and wait for about a minute for the readings to stabilize. Step 3. Interpret the results. The SpO2 tells you the blood oxygen saturation value, and like I've mentioned above, healthy levels will be 95% and above. Low levels will be 90 to 94%, and anything below 90% is dangerously low. If your reading is below 95%, you should seek medical attention right away. The HR or the PR tells you the pulse rate, and if your heart rate reading is above 100, you would also need to see your doctor urgently. Thank you for watching this video. Learn how to use the pulse oximeter properly so that you can have a more accurate assessment of your own condition at home. Subscribe, like, and share this video if it was beneficial to you. Till the next time, stay safe, stay healthy.